Hello, hello, and welcome to another tutorial. Today we will learn how to vertically align text in CSS using five methods. Method one is a classic one. It will only vertically align one row of text. So to see this, let's make one div with a class container. Okay, it will be container one. And one p tag with a class text one. Okay, and let's add some text inside lorem ipsum, and let's trim a bit so we have only one line. And in our main CSS we will add some styling for our container one. We will add background color of white, just to better see our in the preview pane on the right side. And this is a very simple method, so just use on your text one, just use height of 100 pixels, for example, and line height of 100 pixels. And as you can see, this is our text is in the center. But if we add another line of text over here, it will break, as you can see over here. So this works only for one row. Okay, I just add method two. Method two will be the upgrade of a method one. So we just add again our container and text paragraph. Okay, just copy this from the method one and paste it down there, and change the number two and text two, so it will be easy to work with. Okay, in our CSS we got our container two and a text two. As you can see, we will now add to the container two this code. We'll add height and the line height of 100 pixels, and as you can see, our text is in the center, aligned in the center. But as you can see, if we also add one, it will one additional a row, it will break. So to be able to add add additional row, we need to add to our text to display inline block, and say vertical align middle. As you can see, nothing still happens, because nothing will happen until you add line height normal. And as you can see on the right side, our method works and it's in the center. So let's check with another row, just say lorem. Ta-da! As you can see, our text is in the center again. In method three, we will use table illusion to vertically align our text. So just copy this code up here, your container and the text two, and paste it down here, and just change the numbers here, three. And to do this, we need to set for our container three to, okay, just a second. Okay, our container tree to display a table, and now we said to our container to act as a table. We can say our height is 300 pixels, and background color to also be white. And on our text tree, we add display table cell, as you can see. We now treat our text tree as a table cell, and only thing you need to add is vertical align middle, and this is it. You can change the height over here for, I don't know, 200 pixels and so on. As you can see, our text is in the middle, vertically aligned perfectly, and we can have multiple rows. Method 4 is my favorite one next to a method 5. That's why I left them for the end of this tutorial. And because I like them so much, because they need so little coding. So let's, for example, add in our index.html, let's just copy paste as usual our code and paste it down there, change this to number 4 so we don't have to write all over again, and we use padding, so it will be just on our container 4. We just add background color just to see it better, this pretty white color, and just add padding, top and bottom padding to be the same, for example 50 pixels, and the right and the left to be 0, and as you can see, our content is centered. It is my favorite method because next to a flexbox, it's the easiest method and it works everywhere. As you can see, you can also add this padding in percents, for example, 5%, and so it will be always responsive. And method 5 is a flexbox. It's my personal favorite next to a padding. All we need to do is make again, copy our code, remove this number and say it's number 5, and all you need to do is to add to a container 5, add some flex rules, so say display flex, okay, and we say justify content on center. And as you can see over here, I'm sorry, and add the background color to be also white, so we can see our content, and say flex direction column, and that's it. As you can see, our content in a container 5 is perfectly vertically aligned. Which method is the best method? I can say you none of these methods above is perfect, and it's not adequate for all occasions. The trick is to understand them and to apply and use each appropriately. Some of the methods work better for inline elements and some work better for block level elements. It's all about the web developer. And sooner or later the flexbox method will prevail, and that's a good stuff to know, because we will have only one method that works, and call it a day. That's it for today, and thank you for watching, and bye bye.